Joshua Gibson was born on December 21st, 1911, and he was an American baseball catcher primarily in the Negro Leagues. Baseball historians consider Mr. Gibson to be among the very best power hitters and catchers in baseball history. And in 1972, he became the second Negro League player to be inducted in the National Baseball Hall of Fame. Mr. Gibson played for the Homestead Grays from 1930 to 1931, moved to the Pittsburgh Crawfords from 1932 to 1936, and returned to the Grays from 1937 to 1939 and 1942 to 1946. In 1937, he played for the Ciudad Trujillo in Trujillo's Dominican League, and from 1940 to 1941, he played in the Mexican League for the Rojos de Aguila de Veracruz. Mr. Gibson served as the first manager of the Santurce Crabbers, one of the most historic franchises of the Puerto Rico Baseball League, and Mr. Gibson was known as the Black Babe Ruth. In fact, some fans at the time who saw both Ruth and Gibson play called Ruth the White Josh Gibson. Mr. Gibson never played in the major leagues because of the unwritten gentleman's agreement that prevented non-white players from participating. He stood 6'1" and weighed 210 pounds at the peak of his career. On December 16, 2020, Major League Baseball announced that it will recognize Negro League records, giving Mr. Gibson the Major League record for single season batting average with a .441 batting average. So, that's just an intro. Now let's take a deep dive into Mr. Josh Gibson. Mr. Gibson was born in Buena Vista, Georgia, to Mark and Nancy Woodlock. And Mr. Gibson had a younger brother and a younger sister. And in 1923, Mr. Gibson moved to Pittsburgh, and his father found work at the Carnegie, Illinois Steel Company. Entering sixth grade in Pittsburgh, Mr. Gibson prepared to become an electrician, attending Allegheny Pre-Vocational School and Conroy Pre-Vocational School. His first experience playing baseball for an organized team came at age 16 when he played third base for an amateur team sponsored by Gimbel's department store, where he found work as an elevator operator. Shortly thereafter, he was recruited by the Pittsburgh Crawfords, which in 1928 was still a semi-professional team. The Crawfords, controlled by Gus Greenlee, was the top black semi-professional team in the Pittsburgh area and would advance to fully professional major Negro League status by 1931. In 1928, Mr. Gibson met Helen Mason, whom he married on March 7, 1929. When not playing baseball, Mr. Gibson continued to work at Gimbel's, having given up on his plans to become an electrician to pursue a baseball career. In the summer of 1930, the 18-year-old Gibson was recruited by Cumberland Posey, owner of the Homestead Grays, which was the preeminent Negro League team in Pittsburgh. Mr. Gibson debuted with the Grays on July 31, 1930. On August 11th, Mr. Gibson's wife, who was pregnant with twins, went into premature labor and died while giving birth to a twin son, Josh Gibson Jr., and daughter Helen, named after her mother. The Negro Leagues generally found it more profitable to schedule relatively few league games and allow the teams to earn extra money through barnstorming against semi-professional and other league teams. Thus, it is important to distinguish between records against all competition and records in league games only. For example, against all levels of competition, Mr. Gibson hit 69 home runs in 1934. The same year in league games, he hit 11 home runs in 52 games. In 1933, he hit .467 with 55 home runs in 137 games against all levels of competition. His lifetime batting average is said to be higher than .350, with other sources putting as high as .384, the best in Negro League history. Mr. Gibson's Hall of Fame plaque states he hit almost 800 home runs in league and independent baseball during his 17-year career. This figure includes versus semi-pro competition and in exhibition games. His lifetime batting average, according to the Hall's official data, was .359. It was reported that he won 9 home run titles and 4 batting championships, playing for the Crawfords and the Grays. It is also believed that Mr. Gibson hit a home run in a Negro League game at Yankee Stadium that struck 2 feet from the top of the wall circling the center field bleachers, about 580 feet from home plate. Chicago American Giants infielder Jack Marshall said Mr. Gibson slugged one over the third deck next to the left field bullpen in 1934, the only fair ball hit out of Yankee Stadium. Washington Senators owner Clark Griffith once said that Mr. Gibson hit more home runs into Griffith Stadium's distant left field bleachers than the entire American League. In early 1943, Mr. Gibson fell into a coma and was diagnosed with a brain tumor. After regaining consciousness, he refused the option of surgical removal and lived the next 4 years with recurring headaches. In 1944, Mr. Gibson was hospitalized in Washington, D.C. at Gallagher Hospital for mental observation. On January 20th, 1947, Mr. Gibson died of a stroke at 35 years old in Pittsburgh. So Mr. Josh Gibson was the face of Negro League Baseball. He was the best player during that time. He was the Black Babe Ruth. And what fascinated me about his story is all the things I've heard about him hitting 500-foot home runs, 600-foot home runs, driving the ball consistently. I was in awe about him from the age of 10 years old on. When I first learned about him, I raved about Mr. Josh Gibson. That's how I wanted to hit. I wanted to be that type of player. So that was one of the major reasons why I wanted to share his story, because you can't tell the story of Negro League Baseball without talking about Mr. Gibson. So I want to thank you for watching. I want to know what your thoughts are. You can hit the like button if you like this. It'll help me with the YouTube algorithm. And please hit the subscribe button if you're new here. I have more content like this for the next few days until the end of February. And I want to just thank you for watching all the way into the end. So with that being said, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.